So hello, my name is Peter Dvianski, and I just uploaded this package to Hackage database, which is called x86-64-bit. And this is a assembler like Harpy, which is a similar package, but this one supports 64-bit code. And some other features I will show very shortly. The size of the operands are statically checked. Immediate values are automatically converted to the smallest size. And Dobrin indices are used instead of labels, which is an interesting feature. And I have quick check tests, so you can quick check your processor now. So I show you very shortly these features. So, for example, I can add, or I can move. To RAX RDY. So these instructions move the 64-bit DI register content into the 64-bit A register. And if I just hit enter now, I get back the the assembly code and the bytes. And I can compile it, or I can execute it. So, for example, I need one more thing to this to work. I have to return with that. Okay, so this is the identity function code, because in the C calling convention, the input is placed in the DI register, and the output is read out from the A register. So I can compile it. And I have to tell what is the type of this function, because there is no type information in assembly. So let's say it's a word 68 to word 68 function. And I can call it, actually, let's say with one. And the result is one. So so that's it. I show a little bit more complicated example. It's a Fibonacci function. Fibonacci function is this is the code for it. I will not explain it. I just compile it and run. So I turn on time measurement. So this is the code of the Fibonacci function, and I compile it. And I call it with 1, okay, with 10, with 100. Okay, no, it will overflow, but I just leave it as it is. So it is 1,000, 10,000, 100,000, 1 million, 10 million, 100 million, and 1 billion. And on this netbook, it still runs in less than 1 second. So I think it's quite impressive. And I show two more examples. So this is a embedded domain-specific language. So you can place something, trace instructions inside the assembly code. This trace register, oh, you don't see the side. So this trace register is combined by other assembly instructions and calling the cprintf function. So if I compile traced FIB code, and call it with 10, okay, trace. That is the traced FIB code. Then I get back the intermediate states of the A register. And one another example, I can call C code from assembly. These are also compound instructions. I just defined it by means of basic assembly instructions. And I can call printf like this. So good. I run it. Okay. Uh-huh, it works. Hello world. And I can call Haskell from assembly like this. This is the Fibonacci function, so I call it. These are the assembly instructions. Okay, this is this seems like some random number, but this is the address of the Fibonacci function in Haskell. So I can call it like and it works. So it's that easy to use it. And now I show how to quick check my processor. I just run tests. And it generated 2,000 instructions, jumped to it, and tested whether the result is the same as in the specification. Okay. So these were the instructions.
The specification was about the contents of the registers.
The content of the registers and the flags. Some of the flags, not all.
And what if someone writes a specification for a code that crashes?
Then quick check will crash and we could not report what was the wrong instruction, so unfortunately.
That part is unfortunately not tested.
If it runs and if it's okay, then it's okay. If it runs and tells not okay, then it's not okay. If it runs and crashes, it's not okay. So it's easy to check. So any questions? Then thanks.